fun show. Darcy, that was incredible. If Darcy here has anything to do with it, well, the next 30 minutes, you're going to be thrilled, baffled, entertained, the whole lot.
It's going to be amazing. Later on the show, we have an incredible escape from Darcy, and he is here in one piece, which is very good news.
Yes.
We'll be showing you that a little bit later on.
So we saw Darcy make devs appear. Could he do the same with our guest, Patrick?
Oh, yes, absolutely, Alex. Here we go. It's magic. Our next guest tonight, here she comes, ladies and gentlemen. And just keep your eye on this hand here. Ladies and gentlemen, here she comes. It's Natalie Imbruglia! Yeah. Natalie Imbruglia is here!
Magic.
It's good.
I mean, you know, I'll teach you after the show.
Yes.
So the doves came out of the... We still can't work this out.
Honestly, it's just magic.
That's what it is. It's absolutely...
Isn't it, Darcy?
There
it's
you
just
go.
Magic.
That's all it is.
You're not going to tell us...
conspiracy theory.
We've been trying to get it out of you, but you just start breaking
it
off.
Can you do it with shoes?
I like that.
I'll teach you later.
Okay.
That could be a whole new industry.
Yeah. Save loads of money that way.
Save loads of cash there.
Yeah.
So, Natalie, great new album. I was listening to it this morning. I heard you on Chris.
Yes.
You're sounding better than ever.
It was very early. I had to go to bed very early last night.
Yeah, talk us through how that works, because you on The Breakfast Show, it sounded like it was 8 o'clock in the evening. Your voice was perfect.
I have to get at least 8 hours if I'm going to sing that early in the morning. At least. So, yeah. It's quite scary because your voice, normally my voice doesn't wake up till 11 a.m. or something like that. So, but I've been on the promo trail, and I've been in Germany doing lots of early mornings. So I think my voice is a bit used to it.
So you're back with a brand new album called Male, because you've covered lots of different male artists.
Yes.
So how did it feel to be back in the music studio then? Because apparently when you first went in, you thought, oh, is my voice still going to be there? Because it's been a while, hasn't it?
I didn't sing a note apart from when you're singing in the shower for 5 years.
Wow.
So I didn't do a class, I didn't nothing. So I was a bit... I suddenly was in the studio and I said to my producer, I'm not quite sure what's going to come out when I get to the microphone, so bear with me. And he looked really nervous, and of course it was fine, but yeah, it was a bit nerve-wracking.
Okay. But you know, obviously you were talking about being in the studio, just being in the studio, but it was almost by accident that you ended up being back in, because you were acting in LA and then someone just met you and suggested it, isn't it?
Well, I was studying with Ivana Chubbuck. I did 2 years with her. So I was like in class with 30 actors doing scenes every week. And I was in this cafe and this guy was asking me who I was and what I do. And I said, oh, I used to sing and I'm doing this now. And he just hounded me to get back into music. And eventually I went to New York and took a meeting with Primary Wave, who's now my management. So yeah, it was him.
Okay. Well, this is where it all began. We nearly watched the video all the way through because we loved this.
Much.
This
we
is
love
torn.
This so much. We love this so much.
There you are. So that was 97, Natalie.
The attire has changed.
The attire has changed.
And then this is the handsome man that comes in. I actually, after
Jeremy.
Seeing this video, I tried to track down those cords and jumper. And
you did?
I did.
I actually did.
And I thought to myself it would make me more handsome, and it really didn't.
I thought you were going to say you tried to track down the man. That would be even more.
Yes, I did track down the man. And we've been living happily ever after since.
But you've been doing all sorts of things since, Dawn, obviously, as Patrick said, you've been acting out in LA, and you also did a play in Bath, didn't you? Alan Akebones.
Things We Do for Love. I actually toured it regionally, which was amazing for me. I didn't think I'd ever have the confidence to do a play until I did this 2 years of study, and the opportunity came in to audition, and I got the part, and I was like, oh, okay, I'm going to do it.
So will there be more Natalie in theatre?
I'd love to do more theatre. I really enjoyed it. It was terrifying at first, but once I got into my stride, I really enjoyed it.
And there's a little bit of acting in the new video. I think we've got a little
yes.
clip of this. Now, you're going to have to explain this to us. Do we have a little clip? Here we go. We were trying to work this out. Is that a dummy at the table, or have you just killed him and dressed him?
It's a model. It's a model who turned out to be a phenomenal actor. It's a real person until the last shot where it's a mannequin. And I just loved the... Joe Stevenson, who's a film director who wrote that treatment, I just loved it. I loved the whole Stepford Wives vibe and the Mad Max, obviously. I wanted to do the whole outfit.
Yeah, and the outfit is brill on it.
But the guy was brilliant. But at first he was looking at me while I was singing and I said, can you please look over my shoulder? Because it was really off-putting to be singing to someone just looking at you like that with this kind of mummy stare. So
it's very, very good.
So that's the first single, Instant Crush by Daft Punk. You've got Damien Rice on there, all sorts of people. Do you have a favourite on the album?
I like them all for different reasons, but I've been doing some live shows and I've been really enjoying Friday I'm in Love by The Cure.
Which is perfect for today.
Exactly.
Now, see, I think there's a great version because there's only two types of music, country and Western. There really is. This makes me smile so much.
It's a bit of a different take on it. We kind of did a hoedown.
Oh, it's lovely. Well, Natalie's album, Mail, is out today.
Natalie, anything there you'd like to cover yourself?
Give me a minute to think about that.
All right.
Okay. Let's talk about Wales more. Let's get back
more
to
that. Wales.
Now, the moment you've all been waiting for. What you're about to see was recorded as it actually happened earlier out there on the piazza. Like the band Berlin once said, it will take your breath away.
Now, keep your eyes peeled because what you're about to see, you won't believe.
No.
Tonight, what I'm going to attempt is not an illusion, but rather an escape where the consequences could be deadly. I'll have 70 seconds to pick the locks on these regulation Smith & Wesson handcuffs. There's only two ways to get out of a set of cuffs. One is with the key, the other is to pick the lock. So, okay. I want you to just make sure these are, in fact, legitimate cuffs. Tug on them, make sure they don't pull apart. There's no like little button on there that you would have in like a joke shop or something like that.
No, they're hardware. Yeah.
Real, right?
Real.
70 seconds to pick the locks on the cuffs, but I'm gonna have to do it blindly, as I'll be locked inside this wooden crate right here. Come have a look, make sure it is in fact empty. You will notice there are two handholds in the front right here. My hands will go through the front and be handcuffed on the outside of the crate. You'll also notice there are five or six hairpins hanging in the front. This is to obviously aid in the picking of the locks. Excellent, so you're satisfied everything so far is legitimate?
Yep.
Wonderful.
Yep.
Do you happen to have your cell phone on you? We're going to give everybody here a backstage, behind-the-scenes view of the escape from inside the box as it's happening. So you'll be able to see it as we record it with this camera phone right here. Thank you both very much for your help. I do very much appreciate
Darcy.
It. Thank you much.
Best just look
luck,
after
Darcy.
The phone.
I will, of course. And just take a safe distance right over there. Once I'm locked inside the crate, this whole contraption is going to get raised 30 feet into the air. My hands cuffed on the outside of the box. I have 70 seconds to pick the locks on the cuffs, break out of the crate, and grab onto that red rope hanging above the box. All of this needs to take place in 70 seconds, because when that timer hits zero, no matter what, that box is coming crashing to the ground. The BBC and everybody involved have been instructed that once the timer starts, we will not stop. Once the box goes up, there's only one way it's coming down. Now, we're gonna give you a behind the scenes view right here with the camera. London, are you ready?
Yeah!
Let's begin. When the timer gets down to 10 seconds, please, everybody in the audience, count down with it as I'm completely in the dark inside here. I'll have no idea how much time is left on the timer. So please, when it gets to 10 seconds, everybody count down all the way to zero. Here we go.
Ready? You ready? Darcy, watch ahead. Watch your hands, Darcy. Darcy, are you ready?
Ready.
All clear? Bring it up.
Lost for words, Darcy, I'll be honest.
I know, that was amazing. That, you know, we were out there, we watched it again, and your face watching
Unbelievable. I was getting really nervous, actually.
So was I.
Yeah. But the phone's safe as well.
The phone is safe.
No, it's unbelievable. You came to prominence on Britain's Got Talent last year, but how long have you been doing magic for all then?
It's been a lifetime, I would say. Probably the same with everything you do, right? It's an ongoing process. You know, you're constantly working on stuff. I was probably 7 or 8. When I like full on just started doing it, and then just
look, there you go. Look at this.
Where did you get that? How do you have that?
There he is. It's
magic.
Doing his first tricks.
I don't recall signing anything, saying you can hear that.
Those tricks are now available for £1,000.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, you have to phone up my mum to get that. Did you call my mum to get that?
You've got your ways, we've got ours.
That's
all we're gonna say.
Crafty.
So a trick like that, obviously, you can practice those small tricks, but some you can't practice that big one, can you?
Well, something like that you sort of rehearse in phases, right? Like I'll practice picking the cuffs and, you know, doing it as quickly as I can, and then I'll practice trying to get out of the crate, and you never really do it all in one thing when it's dangerous like that. So yeah, we'll do it in segments, and then, you know, it's nerve-wracking because the first time you do it in one cohesive thing is in the performance, so things can go wrong for sure.
And it's so much more difficult to impress people these days with the internet. People have seen everything.
Absolutely.
But everybody here and everybody out there, I mean, we still can't work it out.
I hope so.
No. But you're on tour doing some big-scale tricks like we saw.
Yes. It
starts in September. What sort of illusions can people expect then on that tour?
Well, it was important to me not to, like, recycle anything from Britain's Got Talent or the Christmas special that we did earlier. So it's majority, I would say, 80% brand-new material. The closer frightens me because it's something that's, you know, super dangerous again. And it's almost like becoming this, like, inner, not battle, but it's like, at what point is it, you know, when
silly.
You stop doing the dangerous stuff? But, I mean, that's what the people want to see. That's what I'm going to give them, so.
How does your mum feel about it?
Not good. And it's, I mean, I didn't tell her about this, so she's going to see it on the, she stalks my Twitter, so she's going to be on there. And she's going to phone me up and yell at me for sure.
But. Brilliant.
It's absolutely amazing.
It was. It's been a great show. Thank you very much, Natalie. Your album, Mail, is out today.
Darcy Tour, remind us about that. That's going to be out.
The tour. Yeah, tour starts mid-September. It goes through the UK. And we also have a book coming out September 3rd as well. So looking forward to that.
Okay. I'll be back on Monday with Richard Blackwood, and our guest will be Sanjeev Bhaskar. Have a great weekend, and thank you very much, Patrick.
Why, thank you,
Pleasure,
madam.
As always.